मंत्री श्रीमती स्मृति ईरानी जी, स्वास्थ्य और परिवार कल्याण मंत्री डॉक्टर मनसुख भाई मांडविया जी, माननीय राज्य मंत्री डॉक्टर मुंजीपुरा महेंद्र भाई, माननीय राज्य मंत्री डॉक्टर भारती प्रवीण पवार जी, महिला और बाल विकास मंत्रालय के सचिव इंदिवर पांडे जी, स्वास्थ्य और परिवार कल्याण मंत्रालय के सचिव श्री राजेश भूषण जी, गणमान्य अतिथिगण, देश भर से आए हुए आंगनवाड़ी कार्यकर्ता और इस समारोह में भाग लेने वाले सभी मित्रों, सबको मेरे ओर से अभिनंदन और नमस्कार। इस महत्वपूर्ण विषय पर श्री राष्ट्रीय सम्मेलन को संबोधित करते हुए आप सभी के बीच में आकर मुझे बहुत हर्ष हो रहा है, क्योंकि दिस इज ए नेशनल ड्यूटी एंड वी ऑल हैव डिसाइडेड टू ज्वाइन टुगेदर, कम टुगेदर टू ज्वाइन इन दिस मिशन, पर्टिकुलरली वुमन द विनर्स अगेंस्ट द टीबी। 2025 तक भारत को टीबी से मुक्त बनाने का लक्ष्य हासिल करने के लिए ऐसी एक रणनीति जरूरी होगी जिसमें महिलाओं के सक्रिय सहभागिता हो। ये केवल महिलाओं का काम नहीं, महिलाओं को भी साथ लेना, पुरुष भी साथ मिलकर काम करना, सरकार भी इसमें लगना और स्वयंसेवक संगठन भी लगना और साथ ही साथ सब मिलकर इसको एक जन आंदोलन का रूप देना, तभी हमारा लक्ष्य संभव होगा। मैं सबसे पहले स्मृति ईरानी जी को, मनसुख भाई को और दोनों के सहयोगियों को अभिनंदन देना चाहता हूँ, क्योंकि ये दोनों मंत्रालय एक साथ आके इस महत्वपूर्ण कार्यक्रम के बारे में एक राष्ट्रीय बहस, राष्ट्रीय प्रयास के लिए ये समारोह का आमंत्रित किया है। मुझे खुशी है कि ये केवल इस समारोह में हमारा संसद भाग ले रहे, मगर साथ ही साथ टीबी से मुक्त के लिए काम करने वाली संस्थाएं, आंगनवाड़ी कार्यकर्ता, टीबी को हराने वाले महिला तथा अन्य हितधारक भी भाग ले रहा है। दैट्स व्हाई आई एम पर्टिकुलरली हैप्पी। वी आर ऑल अवेयर द ट्यूबरक्लोसिस रिमेन्स वन ऑफ द डॉन्टिंग ग्लोबल हेल्थ चैलेंजेस। इट हैज क्लेम्ड अबाउट 1.5 मिलियन lives in 2020. It affects million more, causing a debilitating social and economic impact on their lives. So developing countries with large population such as ours naturally have a high TB burden, posing critical health challenge to our system. I am not going into those statistics, they are already made available to you. Given its wide-ranging impact, global situation and also the initiatives such as WHO's End TB Strategy, United Nations Sustainable Development Goals and the United Nations General Assembly High-Level Meeting on TB have been significant. India, led by our Prime Minister, has taken many flagship initiatives. And the Prime Minister has also set a target for all of us. By 2025, India should become TB Mukt. So this is a challenging task. This task can be fulfilled, I am sure, going by the experience of the youngster, 22-year-old youngster, and also housewife from a rural area in Uttar Pradesh. It shows that if you have the determination, if you have the conviction, and if you have the courage, you'll be able to defeat this This is the lesson we have to understand and join together. One is the government initiative of surveillance system, and also one important aspect of this is Nikshay Poshan Abhiyan. Poshan, nutrition, is very important in this fight against TB. The country, the central government, state government, women's welfare, child welfare, all has to join together in providing nutritious meal to our children, in guiding them also in a proper manner. We have even today 22% poverty around. 20 or 22, whatever, 18 or. It's a big task. Keeping that in mind, we should focus on giving nutritious food to the vulnerable children by taking care of their families. Government of India has come out with many initiatives. The focus is on that. I am sure with their efforts and with also the awareness among the people, we'll be able to overcome this. Another important aspect is poor air quality also affects outdoor and indoor. Poor air quality, poor nutrition, and lack of medical proper care attention timely. These are the important factors that has to be taken note by one and all, and all efforts should be made in that direction. This disease will not only have physical impact, the disease causes a substantial economic and social impact on the lives of the people. This is another important aspect. And also the stigma, social stigma, which causes mental agony to the person affected, to the family also. So this is totally unacceptable, and this should be stopped, and we must all move towards change of mindset. The disease is curable and preventable. The stigma attached to it makes it more difficult to screen the disease at an early stage because people do not come forward because of this stigma. 26 lakh estimated new TB cases in 2020. 18 lakh were reported to the TB program, signifying a wide gap of 8 lakh between the estimated incidents and identified TB cases reported to the government. This administration, how the reality is in the society. While the prevalence of TB is higher among men than women, it can have a disproportionate higher impact on women. The susceptibility of women to TB increased due to the fact that adequate priority is not given to their health, wellness, and nutrition. I'm told that the TB has been responsible for the death of more women in the reproductive age group than all causes of maternal mortality combined. Facing the misery of the abandonment and violence found to have TB, it is not surprising that there is a large number of unreported, therefore untreated cases of TB amongst women. So this has to be taken note. In this connection, I would urge upon the members of parliament, members of the legislative assembly, elected members, and also the local body representatives, political parties, to go for a massive campaign about this disease, about the need to take preventive steps, about providing pure air, good air, about providing the timely medical care. You people have a greater responsibility because we are elected representatives. So I call upon the elected representatives across the country to join this movement and make it more effective and involve people. so as to make it as a Janandolan. This is my particular appeal to the elected representatives. The state governments also should take proactive steps. They must go for door-to-door screening of every individual, especially women who may not be willing to approach healthcare systems on their own. But most importantly, there is also great need for better awareness and advocacy programs, the television, private as well as public channels, the media, the cinema, and also the other stakeholders must also take a proactive role in creating this social awareness. The message of centrality of the message is that TB is definitely preventable and curable. I underline preventable and curable. This awareness has to be created among people. If you want to achieve this target by 2025, we must have a multi-pronged strategy. The time of pandemic, we have seen that during COVID, people have become aware of their lung health. It is gratifying to note that during the pandemic, Health Ministry has adopted a bi-directional COVID TB screening to improve case findings. In the same way, TB advocacy programs should utilize this highlighted awareness among the people and spread the message about the disease. This is my suggestion to the ministry. It should also be highlighted that there are several risks that could increase the chances of TB. Ultimately, people should become key partners in achieving our goal to make India TB Mukta Bharat. The effort and the greater convergence at the district level is more important between Women and Child Development Ministry, Rural Development, Urban Development, and Health and Family Welfare. This also is an important aspect. I hope that all concerned will join together and coordinate their efforts. Members of Parliament, apart from raising the issue in Parliament, they should be the focal point for creating awareness among the people. I would like to compliment the two sisters, the young girl, Arsini, and the other sister for coming together boldly and explaining to the people, to this conference, to country, because this also is being live telecast, so that the people get more awareness. A gender positive program through collaborative effort will contribute hugely achieving the goal of TB free India. Swadhinata ke baad, poshan star mein sudhar tada, jameen star tak swasth suvidhaye पहुंचाने से भारत ने अनेक स्वास्थ्य मानकों पर उल्लेखनीय प्रगति की है, लेकिन टीबी के खिलाफ लड़ाई अभी भी अधूरी है। इसे समाप्त करने के लिए हमारे साझे समन्वित प्रयास जरूरी होंगे। टीबी को समाप्त करने के उद्देश्य से केंद्र और राज्य सरकारों ने मिलकर सार्थक प्रयास किए हैं। टीबी के खिलाफ लड़ाई में हम इसी प्रकार दलीय भावना से ऊपर उठकर टीम इंडिया के रूप में निरंतर प्रयास करते रहना होगा। साथ मिलकर हम टीबी को हरा सकते और अवश्य हराएंगे भी। हम एक रोग व्याध मुक्त, व्याधि मुक्त स्वस्थ भारत के लिए प्रयास करते रहेंगे। टीबी हरेगा, देश जीतेगा। जय हिंद।
कोटेश्वर, धन्यवाद माने।